Good evening, and thank you for joining us for our virtual Good Friday service. I hope you and your family are doing well today. Hey, just wanted to bring a couple of things to your attention as we begin the service tonight. First off, you and your family hopefully received one of these GCC Lent kits. We pass these out right around Ash Wednesday time back in February. This box has some of the things that you'll need for tonight. You'll notice that there's 12 candles in your box. So if you want to, go ahead and take a couple of moments to set your candles up for the evening if you haven't already. You can look at this picture here to see the arrangement of the candles. You should arrange all 12 candles in the arrangement of a cross. And so I'll give you just a couple of moments to set your candles up, because the candles are kind of an important aspect of what we are doing here tonight. And the other thing you'll need from your box is a communion cup, one for each person in your family. And so once you have your candles set up, we will go ahead and get started this evening. What we're going to do before we begin with the Good Friday scripture readings and everything is we're going to just spend a little bit of time opening up with the Lord's Supper, celebrating communion, because this is something Jesus practiced the night before Good Friday with his disciples during the Last Supper. And so on the night he was betrayed, Jesus took the bread. And so take the bread from the cup. Jesus took the bread and he says, this is for my body, which is broken for you. Do this in remembrance of me. Go ahead and take the bread with me this evening. And after the dinner, in the same way, Jesus took the cup of wine and he said, this is my blood that is spilled for you. Drink this cup as often as you gather to remember me. And so tonight we are going to take the cup together as we conclude the Lord's Supper. And remember, we're reflecting on Good Friday, the sacrifice Jesus made for us. The spilling of his blood is what is represented by Good Friday. And so as you drink this cup this evening, remember that sacrifice as we get started tonight. Amen. Well, tonight, as we mentioned, the candles are going to be a driving force of what we do this evening. The tenebrae service is something that has been celebrated for centuries. It's been practiced from different kinds of churches and different kinds of traditions within the church for a long time. And basically, you'll notice you have 12 candles, and each candle represents one disciple of Jesus. And so the idea is that all the candles begin in the evening being lit. And so hopefully you've had a moment to set all your candles up. Hopefully they're all lit at the moment. And each time we have a scripture read this evening, one candle per scripture will be blown out. And as the night progresses, the room will become darker and darker, symbolizing the darkness that came over the land, the darkness that came over the earth when Jesus finally said, it is finished. And so tonight, you will see scripture readings from different people that are members of our church. And so I hope that you will just take time tonight to reflect on Christ, reflect on his sacrifice for us, and reflect on your own relationship with him and the meaning of his sacrifice on Good Friday for you personally. So tonight I'm going to start us off with the first scripture reading, and then we will have our first candle blown out. Luke chapter 22, verses 39 through 44 says, and he came out and went, as was his custom, to the Mount of Olives, and the disciples followed him. And when he came to the place, he said to them, pray that you may not enter into temptation. And he withdrew from them about a stone's throw, and he knelt down and prayed, saying, Father, if you are willing, remove this cup from me. Nevertheless, not my will, but yours be done. And there appeared to him an angel from heaven, strengthening him. And being in agony, he prayed most earnestly. And his sweat became like great drops of blood falling down to the ground.
Luke 22. While he was still speaking, a crowd came up, and a man who was called Judas, one of the 12, was leading them. He approached Jesus to kiss him, but Jesus asked him, "Judas, why are you betraying the Son of Man with a kiss?" When Jesus' followers saw what was going to happen, they said, "Lord, should we strike with our swords?" And one of them struck the servant of the high priest, cutting off his right ear. But Jesus answered, "No more of this." And he touched the man's ear and healed him. Then Jesus said to the chief priests, the officers of the temple guard, and the elders who had come for him, "Am I leading a rebellion that you have come with swords and clubs?"
Then they seized him and led him away, bringing him into the high priest's house. And Peter was following at a distance. And when they had kindled a fire in the middle of the courtyard and sat down together, Peter sat down among them. Then a servant girl, seeing him as he sat in the light, looking closely at him, said, "This man also was with him." But he denied it, saying, "Woman, I did not know him." And a little later, someone else saw him and said, "You also are one of them." But Peter said, "Man, I am not." And after an interval for about an hour, still another insisted, saying, "Certainly this man was also with him, for he too is a Galilean." But Peter said, "Man, I do not know what you are talking about." And immediately, while he was still speaking, the rooster crowed. Reading from Luke 22, verse 54 to 60. Amen.
To see the King of Heaven fall in anguish to his knees, the light and hope of all the world, now overwhelmed with grief. What nameless horrors must he see to cry out in the garden, "Oh, take this cup away from me, yet not my will but yours, yet not my will but yours." To know which friend will fall away and heaven's voice be still, for hell to have its vengeful day upon Golgotha's hill. No words describe the Savior's plight, to be by God forsaken, till rotten love are satisfied and every sin is paid, and every sin is paid. What took him to this wretched place? What kept him on his road? His love for Adam's cursed race, for every broken soul. No sin too slight to overlook, no crime too great to carry. All mingled in this poison cup, and yet he drank it all. The Savior drank it all. The Savior drank it all.
Luke chapter 22, verses 66 through 71. Jesus before Pilate and Herod. At daybreak, the council of the elders of the people, both the chief priests and the teachers of the law, met together, and Jesus was led before them. If you are the Messiah, they said, tell us. Jesus answered, if I tell you, you will not believe me, and if I asked you, you would not answer. But from now on, the Son of Man will be seated at the right hand of the mighty God. They all asked, are you then the Son of God? He replied, you say that I am. Then they said, why do we need any more testimony? We have heard it from his own lips.
The whole company of them arose and brought him before Pilate, and they began to accuse him, saying, we found this man misleading our nation and forbidding us to give tribute to Caesar, and saying that he himself is Christ the king. And Pilate asked him, are you the king of the Jews? And he answered him, you have said it. On hearing this, Pilate asked if the man was a Galilean. When he learned that Jesus was under Herod's jurisdiction, he sent him to Herod, who was also in Jerusalem at the time. Luke 23, verses 1 through 6.
Luke chapter 23, 8 through 12. When Herod saw Jesus, he was very glad, for he had long desired to see him because he had heard about him, and was hoping to see some sign done by him. So he questioned him at some length, but he made no answer. The chief priests and scribes stood by him, vehemently accusing him, and Herod and his soldiers treated him with contempt and mocked him. Then, arraying him with splendid clothing, they sent him back to Pilate. And Herod and Pilate became friends with each other that very day. For before this, they had been at an enmity with each other.
A reading from Luke 23, verses 13 through 21. Pilate called together the chief priests, the rulers, and the people, and said to them, you brought me this man as one who was inciting people to rebellion. I have examined him in your presence and have found no basis for your charges against him. Neither has Herod, for he sent him back to me. As you can see, he has done nothing to deserve death. Therefore, I will punish him and then release him. But the crowd shouted, away with this man. Release Barabbas. Barabbas had been thrown into prison for an insurrection in the city and for murder. Wanting to release Jesus, Pilate appealed to them again, but they kept shouting, crucify him, crucify him.
A third time he said to them, "Why? What evil has he done? I have found in him no guilt deserving death. I will therefore punish and release him." But they were urgent, demanding with loud cries that he should be crucified, and their voices prevailed. So Pilate decided that their demand should be granted. He released the man who had been thrown into prison for insurrection and murder, for whom they asked that he deliver Jesus over to their will.
Man of sorrows, Lamb of God, by his own betrayed, the sin of man and wrath of God has been on Jesus laid. Silent as he stood accused, beaten, mocked, and scorned, bowing to the Father's will, he took a crown of thorns. Rugged cross, my salvation, where your love poured out over me. Now my soul cries out, hallelujah, praise and honor unto Sent of heaven, God's own Son, to purchase and redeem, and reconcile the very ones who nailed him to the tree. My salvation, where your love poured out over me. Now my soul cries out, hallelujah, praise and honor unto thee. Now my death, it is paid in full by the precious blood that my Jesus spilled. Now the curse of sin has no hold on me, whom the Son sets free. Oh, is free indeed. Now my debt is paid. Paid in full by the precious blood that my Jesus spilled. Now the curse of sin has no hold on me, whom the Son sets free. Oh, is free indeed. Oh, the rugged cross, my salvation, where your love poured out over me. Now my soul cries out, hallelujah, praise and honor unto thee. stone is rolled away. Behold the empty tomb. Hallelujah, God be praised. He's risen from the grave. Oh, the rugged cross, my salvation, where your love poured out over me. Now my soul cries out, hallelujah. And honor on to thee. Praise and honor on to thee. Praise and honor on to thee.
And as they led him away, they seized one Simon of Cyrene, who was coming in from the country, and laid on him the cross to carry it behind Jesus. Two others who were criminals were led away to be put to death with him. And when they came to the place that is called the Skull, there they crucified him and the criminals, one on his right and one on his left. And Jesus said, Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do.
Luke, chapter 23, verses 35-38, ESV. And the people stood by, watching. But the rulers scoffed at him, saying, He saved others, let him save himself, if he is the Christ of God, his chosen one. The soldiers also mocked him, coming up and offering him sour wine, and saying, If you are the King of the Jews, save yourself. There was also an inscription over him, This is the King of the Jews.
Luke 23, verses 39-43. One of the criminals who were hanged railed at him, saying, Are you not the Christ? Save yourself and us. But the other rebuked him, saying, Do you not fear God, since you are under the same sentence of condemnation? And we indeed justly, for we are receiving the due justice for what we have done. This man has done nothing wrong. And he said, Jesus, remember me when you come into your kingdom. And Jesus said to him, Truly I say to you, today you will be with me in paradise.
Above all powers, above all kings, above all nature and all created things, above all wisdom and all the ways of man, you were here before the world began.
Kingdoms, above all thrones, above all the wonders the world has ever known, above all the wealth and treasures of the earth, there's no way to measure what you're worth.
Laid behind a stone, you lived to die, rejected and alone, like a rose trampled on the ground. You took the fall.
taught me above all. Above all powers, above all kings, above all nature and all created things, above all wisdom and all the ways of man, you were here before the world began.
Above all kingdoms, above all thrones, above all the wonders the world has ever known, above all the wealth and treasures of the earth, there's no way to measure what you're worth.
Crucified, laid behind a stone, you lived to die, rejected and alone, like a rose trampled on the ground, you took the fall, taught me above all. Crucified, laid behind a stone, you lived to die, rejected and alone, like a rose trampled on the ground, you took the fall and taught me above all. Like a rose trampled on the ground, you took the fall and taught me above all.
As we enter into our final reading for this evening, a couple quick things to keep in mind coming up. On Sunday, we will be gathering in person. If you're going to join us for Easter Sunday, we do have registrations online so that we could adhere to the number of people that's safe to gather with. So you can find all that registration online. It's www.gracecovssf.com. You can register there too, so that we can expect to see you on Sunday morning to celebrate Easter together. And secondly, after I read this final scripture, the screen's just going to go blank and we're going to take just a moment to take a deep breath and to reflect on everything that we've heard, everything that we've prayed, everything that we've sang tonight. So as soon as that screen goes blank, our time together is completed, but we encourage you to take those couple of moments to reflect for yourself on what you've heard God say this evening. With that, I invite you to hear these final words this evening out of John chapter 19. Later, knowing that everything had now been finished and so the scripture would be fulfilled, Jesus said, "I am thirsty." A jar of wine vinegar was there, so they soaked a sponge in it, put the sponge on the stalk of a hyssop plant, and lifted it to Jesus' lips. When he had received the drink, Jesus said, "It is finished." With that, he bowed his head and gave up